In this region, the most well-preserved remains of ancient animals, mammoths, horses, cave lions, have been found. Curious to know which region is being discussed? Then be sure to watch this video. And if you watch it to the end, you'll learn about the most unusual discovery by paleontologists in all modern history. Honestly, it surprised me a lot. Enjoy watching! The remains of this animal are found practically everywhere – in Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, and other regions. The mammoth – a huge elephant with majestic tusks and warm fur. It lived during the Pliocene and Holocene epochs, about 5 million to 4,500 years ago. Not so long ago, right?
Okay.
And if you know a little bit of history, you'll understand that intelligent humans certainly managed to see this creature alive. And they even depicted the mammoth in cave paintings. Here are drawings from the Rufiak cave, left about 12,000 years ago, before the extinction of these majestic animals. But drawings are not all we have left from those times. There are also a huge number of giant bones. These, for example, are the bones of the Colombian mammoth, native to America. By the way, the largest representative of the family. These are remains from Africa. It seems that only teeth have been preserved in this region. At least, I couldn't find any other pictures. And this is Yuka gir mammoth, native to the Russian Siberia, a perfectly preserved specimen. Even the fur remains! The remains of this 7-foot cub were discovered quite by accident in August 2010 in Yakutia. The age of the mammoth is estimated to be approximately 39,000 years. Researchers believe that Yuka was killed by humans because there are clean cuts on its carcass and some of the meat is missing. This is the first specimen found that shows evidence of mammoths interacting with humans. By the way, have you ever wondered why mammoths became extinct while elephants did not? Is it all because of humans? Strange, isn't it? How could humans destroy such a huge population of large mammals? And back then, without firearms, against such tusks, it's hard for me to imagine. In addition to mammoths, there were other animals on our planet with huge sharp bone formations – unicorns. But not like those, of course, but Siberian ones. Ah! Elasmotheriums, prehistoric odd-toed ungulates, related to modern rhinos, once inhabited the vast expanses of Eastern Europe and Western Siberia. How do scientists know this? They, of course, found the remains. This first happened back in the early 20th century. Yakut schoolchildren found a strange tooth of an ancient creature and brought it to the museum, then another one, and another. And then a whole skeleton. This find caused a real shock among scientists. After all, the creature didn't resemble any other found before, and, according to some data, had a wide skull with one giant horn. Something like this. Yes, 5 feet long! By the way, this is a reconstruction of the Siberian unicorn from the Stavropol Paleontological Museum, located in Russia. Bones are also kept there. The remains, by the way, were found not just once. For example, the most recent find belongs to a regular guy from cold Yakutia, Alexander. In September 2014, while patrolling a hunting area, he noticed fur high on a glacier. He thought it belonged to a deer, but he was wrong. Several days later, when the ice melted and the fur fell from the glacier, Alexander immediately examined the find and realized that it belonged to a rhinoceros. This discovery allowed scientists to specify the appearance of the animal. Now there is an opinion that the Siberian rhinoceros had a more modest horn, not like it was depicted in their early reconstructions. As you may have already guessed, it is Siberia, including Yakutia, that is considered the region where the largest number of well-preserved remains of ancient animals are found. I think this may be related to the climate of this place. Extremely low temperatures, permafrost. Such conditions are excellent for preserving remains, preventing their decomposition. And these findings usually happen by chance. Specialists say not a single known find was discovered during specially planned scientific research. It's a matter of great luck. This fact makes such discoveries even more astonishing. What else has been discovered in Siberia? For example, a cave lion cub. You might say, what's so surprising about it? Everyone knows about lions. Indeed, for almost 200 years, scientists have come across skulls, jaws, and incomplete parts of the skeletons of cave lions. And here, whole carcasses, including fur. Isn't it an amazing find?
Nice.
Two cubs, named Dina and Uyan, were barely a week old when they died. Experts believe that their den collapsed, and the lack of air led to the excellent preservation of their bodies. And in 2018, in the same Yakutia, gold miners working along the Indigirka River stumbled upon something unexpected. Something resembling paws and a tail protruded from the frozen ground. The workers immediately called the authorities to send scientists who could identify the remains. It turned out that the limbs belonged to a Przewalski's horse. Horses, you might say. I've seen a horse a million times in my life. But certainly not like this one. Firstly, it's the only surviving species of wild horses in nature. Secondly, they now only live in Mongolia, whereas they used to have a much larger habitat. So, this find is quite astonishing. It's a genuine ancient horse, living thousands of years ago in these lands. To be more precise, about 35,000 to 40,000 years ago. The position in which the pony was found suggests that it died quickly, presumably from falling and getting stuck in a swamp. Its stomach contained a lot of mud and silt, which it swallowed before death, as well as various herbs and plants that grew in this region thousands of years ago. The mixture quickly froze, so the body was well preserved. All this gives us an idea of the flora of the region at that time and what these ancient horses fed on.
What is he doing?
He's beginning to believe.
Moreover, decay practically did not affect the internal organs. The soft tissues were reddish in color, and black fur remained on the head, legs, and parts of the body. And the most remarkable thing is that scientists managed to extract samples of liquid blood from the heart vessels. They hope to isolate viable cells from them, which could be used to decode the genome and clone the extinct species. Alright, let's move finally to another place, far from Siberia. In year 2000, during archaeological excavation near the German city of Darmstadt, unusual remains were discovered.
Who are you?
The creature outwardly resembled a horse, but still had significant differences. A different skull and legs. The internal bone content was also strange. There were too many bones, including some small specimens, not typical for adult individuals. Finally, scientists determined that the skeleton belonged to an ancient mare and her unborn foal. And if you suddenly, upon hearing these words, imagine the most ordinary horse, I'll surprise you. This creature looked quite different, with four fingers on each front and three on each hind leg instead of hooves, and was about 10 times smaller.
Wow!
The ancient ancestor of horses was the size of a modern fox terrier. By the way, the discovery is more than 48 million years old. Amazing, isn't it? Science has come a long way. And what a wonderful nature. After all, it's she who preserved the bones of such an ancient creature. In 1986, a team of researchers exploring the caves of Mount Owen in New Zealand found an unusual huge claw.
You're teasing me, naughty, naughty!
Like this one. When I look at it, all sorts of horrors come to mind. It seems like the claw of some monster. Of course, I'm wrong. But scientists were also wrong when they mistook this find for the remains of a dinosaur. It turned out that the claw belonged to a moa bird. A bird that became extinct around the year 1500 due to humans. Giant moas were simply enormous. They reached 12 feet in height and weighed around 550 pounds. At the time of their existence, they were the largest birds on Earth, dominant herbivores of New Zealand. They mainly fed on fruits, roots, shoots, and leaves, and sometimes swallowed stones to grind all this in the stomach. By the way, although moa were birds, they couldn't fly at all. They didn't even have wings. Nevertheless, this didn't prevent them from living and thriving until the 13th century, when the Polynesians arrived on this land. They started hunting the large but vulnerable bird. After all, it had so much delicious meat. Eventually, due to the excessive hunting, moa disappeared about 500 years ago. By the way, the found claw is not just 500 years old, but a whole 3,500. Archaeologists were surprised because the claw was almost undamaged.
What?
Even the muscles and skin were preserved on it. It's interesting. Why is that? Why didn't the other claws survive? And the next discovery will astonish all entomophobes. That is, people who are afraid of insects. Imagine, you are walking in the forest and suddenly see an ant size of a bird. You'll say, impossible. And I'll say, it's absolutely possible. But only not in our time, but 50 million years ago. During the Eocene epoch, giant insects were a reality. And confirmation of this fact was recently discovered by American scientists. This fossil indicates that at that time, ants were truly massive. The largest specimens could have a body length of about 2 inches and a wingspan of up to 6. Creepy, isn't it?
What?
It is believed that at that time, the planet's climate was more favorable, warmer, on average about 50 degrees Fahrenheit warmer. Lush forests grew everywhere. Various beetles and lizards scurried around. In general, it was an excellent atmosphere for a good life. Then, the global temperature started to cool, and many creatures, including insects, began to face difficulties, and eventually became extinct. And I think it's even fortunate. I wouldn't want to meet such an ant face to face. By the way, here's a photo of the largest specimen ever found. This is a female of ancient ants from Germany, not from America. So these giant insects existed not only on the continent. Alright, why are we all focused on land creatures? Let's finally dive underwater, into the depths. After all, even in our time, you can find many amazing things there. Not to mention the remains of ancient beings. For example, just some 70 to 66 million years ago, the world's oceans were ruled by a bloodthirsty predatory lizard the size of a three-story house.
How?
The Mosasaur. Can you imagine that? Let me show you. Here are the remains of the largest monster ever found. And these are its impressive teeth. Close-up photo. The size of this skeleton, found just a few years ago by British paleontologist Nick Longridge, is impressive. The skull, 5 feet in length. The body, over 30.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got him.
Of course, it's smaller than modern blue whales, which can be up to 100 feet long. Nevertheless, the appearance of the Mosasaur is frightening. It's like some giant underwater crocodile, don't you think? And this is another large predator of those times. Megalodon, a giant extinct shark. Scientists don't know the exact size figures. Some say it was quite chubby and up to 50 feet long. Others believe that this shark was slender and very long, up to 100 feet or more. One thing is clear, Megalodon had huge sharp teeth in several rows. Take a look for yourself. This tooth measures 4 inches, this one 7, and the shark had 250 of them. This is how a person looks next to the complete jaw. By the way, I found a website where you can buy several such teeth, including in perfect condition. I think you can easily Google it. Prices range from $200 to $5,000.
It's the biggest piece of dog shit.
You probably, like me, are interested. And how did such giants become extinct? The reasons for the demise of megalodons are not entirely clear. Nevertheless, there are several hypotheses about this. The first is that climate change affected food availability, and the second, these sharks couldn't compete with other underwater predators. After all, there were fish even larger. Look, this is a plesiosaur, and this is an image of the Loch-Ness monster. Let's repeat, plesiosaur, Loch-Ness monster. Am I the only one who sees that they are very similar to each other?
Huh?
Alright, let's go in order. Plesiosaurs are the oldest marine reptiles, which are perhaps the best studied prehistoric species at the moment, because a lot of skeletons of these animals have been found. Hundreds of different remains in various parts of the planet. In America, Europe, Asia, in the islands of the Pacific Ocean. Plesiosaur, a large marine predator, originating from the late Cretaceous period. That is, it lived about 227 to 66 million years ago. Why then do people still manage to find well-preserved remains of this creature to this day? For example, 1977 brought a very interesting surprise for cryptozoologists. Near New Zealand, a Japanese trawler caught a huge decomposing carcass. Doesn't it remind you of anything? And this find was made by residents of Scotland, living not far from the world-famous lake. A gnawed carcass from which only the skeleton held together by ligaments and a few intestines remained. If you add 1 plus 1, you might think that Loch Ness still harbors ancient underwater predators, plesiosaurs. And it is they who scare tourists and residents of the town and become the legends of myths and stories.
Hello, guys!
But all this, of course, is just conspiracy theories and myths. We are unlikely to find out the truth, at least not in the near future for sure. These are the unusual creatures that once inhabited our planet. Who knows, maybe we'll soon have more interesting discoveries in Siberia or in any other part of the world. Thanks for watching.